Hey everyone, welcome back to Taproot TV. I'm Benny Hughes, and it's been a long time since I've had you in this chair,
Kendry. It seems like it. I don't know what happened.
I don't either.
You've been busy.
You've been replaced.
Been busy
a lot.
That's all right.
Well, I'm glad to have you back. We're going to talk about the 2020 Taproot Global Summit, which will be here before we know it, March 9th
comes
through
quick.
The 13th.
It comes quick. It seems like a long way away, but it's less than 6 months now.
It is September now.
I know.
So it's like, how did that happen?
Right.
You are in charge of a very good track. I'm curious to hear about this.
Yeah.
Achieving Excellence and Reliability.
Right.
Tell me, what is that track about?
Yeah, so this is to try to give you some ideas when you're at your company to improve your improvement programs. What can we do to not just generic root cause analysis and kind of the things you think about with Taproot, but what else can we do at our companies to make our processes better, and maybe some different ways of using Taproot. Sometimes we're so locked in on instant investigations and even doing proactive stuff, but
right.
We're going to show you some ideas maybe to some additional ways of using Taproot in your company to try to improve your processes and achieve excellence.
That sounds great, because it sounds a lot like some of what we ended up the summit with last year.
Very similar to that.
With
the roadmap
stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yep.
All right, well, let's, just so you know, it's at Horseshoe Bay, and it's about an hour outside of Austin, Texas, and we're super excited.
One of our favorite places.
It is one of our favorite places.
We held it there several years ago.
Love it there.
Excellent. Yeah.
I know people are excited we're going back.
I know, I heard that too.
So let's say on Wednesday, we get started, ready, set, go. We're going to have Marcus Miller is going to do a keynote on discipline and criminalization and how that will stop accidents. I think that'll be really interesting.
Right.
And then we roll into the best practice sessions, and your first one is on management best practices.
Yeah, this is given by two of our longtime users and friends that are going to be giving this. Jeff Frost and Joel Solomon are going to be giving a couple of sessions here. We kind of break this into two little sessions. And it's really going to be taking a look at, first of all, Joel is going to look at organizational mapping. So how can we look at our organization and use Taproot to help us figure out, do we have an efficient organization? Where do we have holes? What kind of problems are we having? So we're not looking at it as an incident investigation process, but more how can we improve our business processes at our company.
Okay.
So and basically looking at the organization of our company and seeing where our inefficiencies are. Yeah, it's really interesting. I've never seen one done this way, so it's going to be really cool.
I may have to sit in on that one.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's before lunch.
Yep.
And
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you, but Jack Frost then, his second one. So is going to be there looking at how to talk to managers. So when you're trying to explain your Taproot investigations and discuss the results of your investigations, how do I ask for budget? How do I do that? It's important to be able to speak properly to management so that they understand what you're trying to tell them. So it's so he's going to talk.
Because they don't always know what's going on in your world.
No, they're not supposed to know all my little details.
That's what they have you for.
That's right. That's why you're there. So it's it gives you an opportunity to talk a little bit about that.
Okay, great. Mm-hmm. All right, so we'll go to lunch, always wonderful, and then we're going to come back and do convincing management. How much does it cost? And so Jack pulls into this one, too.
He does. Jack Frost and Gard Clark are going to be kind of teaming up on this one, and they're going to get, and Brian Tink is also giving a piece of this.
Lots of expertise in that one.
They're going to look more into the actual ROI. How do I prove all the different costs that are involved in an incident and why it makes sense to implement these corrective actions. And a lot of people don't realize how much cost there is when an incident, whether even big or small, occurs at your company. How that really affects your company. There are so many secondary effects to having an incident, and they're going to discuss this in a lot of detail on how to discuss this with your managers.
Oh, that'll be a great one.
Yeah.
Well, then it looks like we're going to kind of have an example of what Taproot has done for a company. So what Taproot's done for Weatherford.
Yep. Sean Holden's going to talk about some best practices and how they've been able to do some really good improvements at Weatherford and give some examples of how his investigations have been helpful there and how they've kind of shown improvement in their different areas of the company. So
Sean's
really cool.
Great.
Yeah.
We love
yeah.
Sean.
Yeah.
He's fantastic.
Well,
so those are some heavy topics. So it's going to be nice. We're going to have a comedian wind up Wednesday and then our party. So
I've seen some fun stuff of that guy. He is hilarious.
He is.
I'm
I saw the video. I laughed.
It.
I did too.
Yeah.
Definitely some laugh out loud moments. And then Carl Dixon will be back.
Yay!
So he'll sing. He started singing. Everybody sings but me.
I have one song that I do. That's it. No more. No more. I can't do
it. I may dance, but I don't sing. All right, so Thursday, then we'll start again with breakfast. We start a little later on Thursdays because everybody's tired from the party. So your first breakout session is going to be about Taproot user success stories.
Right.
Those are wonderful to hear.
They really are. I think it's important to show how our customers and our users and our friends are able to show how they're passionate about what they do with their company. And how we've been able to help them with their passion and improve their companies. So I'm always excited to see success stories show up on our schedule.
Me too, because I get to give them awards.
That's right.
That's always
fun.
That's
right. Best practice awards. Yeah,
that's true. Improving your manufacturing process.
Yeah, I've got Derek Rutherford and Tammy Mascioli is going to be working on this. They are both from a pharmaceutical background, but they're going to be discussing some details about instead of just looking at Taproot for HS&E kind of problems, looking at quality issues. Tammy has been instrumental at Patheon, now as Thermo Fisher, implementing Taproot for quality control and quality issues to have really high quality product coming out of an FDA kind of controlled business. And she's had huge success with this. So we're really she's relatively new implementer. It's only in the past couple of years that they've been using Taproot and showing some huge benefits. So.
Well, we get lots of questions about using Taproot and quality all the time.
We really do. So this would be some great ideas. And if you're interested in seeing Taproot with quality, this would be a great session to attend. Yeah.
Let's see. Kevin McManus is going to be using Taproot to improve meeting effectiveness and minimize meeting waste. Everybody wants to do that.
I am really looking forward to this topic. I haven't seen the full outline yet, but Kevin is just awesome when he's out there giving these cool talks. And he always has these different nuggets and tidbits on how to use Taproot in these really unusual ways that you would never have thought of, again, to improve your business practices and increase efficiency. So,
well, and meeting effectiveness. We may try to use some of those
I may
tips.
Have to take some serious notes to make sure that we have some good meetings going. Yeah.
All right. Renee Jordan is going to do lessons learned and sharing results.
Yep.
Renee's wonderful.
If you haven't ever listened to Renee, she is so passionate and excited about what she talks about. So, yeah, I always enjoy listening to Renee talk.
Yep. Well, I'm sure she has lots of lessons for everybody to learn.
Yeah.
Mark Paradise is going to wind up that day talking about lives saved and performance improved, which is a great topic. Mark always has so much wealth of knowledge to share.
He really does, I always look forward to his talks.
All right, then the next day, the last day, you have to stay.
You got to stay.
Till the last day, and we wind up around noon, so it's not like you got to stay late.
Lots of time.
Exactly. So we're going to make it worth your while. First of all, we're going to have breakfast. And second, then we're going to do the roadmap to success. Some people were here for that last year, and they get to go phase on through theirs.
Yeah, the roadmap. If you guys weren't there last year, that roadmap, I found that to be an extremely helpful topic. Last year we had so many people stay, or this year I guess, stay for that topic and really felt like they were able to take something home with them about how we're going to improve and how all this cool stuff we just learned at the summit, how we're going to apply that at our companies. And it was more than just list all the stuff you're gonna do.
This was
really looking at how you're gonna get your flow and your improvement processes started and running and then maintained, and how we can be helpful for that if we can, or what things you can put in place at your company.
Yeah, I've still been working with people since the last summit on what they started in that last session. Had a good conversation last week with one of the guys I talked to at the summit.
Oh, that's right.
It's actually, this is probably about 3 or 4 different ones that I've worked with since then, and we've been going down this path, and they've just really found so much value out of it.
Yeah, I think this is this year was the first year we've done this, and I think it was a really nice change, and it seemed to work really well. We had some
people great
feedback.
Were leaving there going, "This is what I need."
Yep.
So we like to hear that, and then we'll wind up with. If you ever saw the movie Catch Me If You Can with Leonardo DiCaprio, Frank Abagnale Jr. is Leo DiCaprio played Frank in the movie.
That's right. He's the guy.
Yeah. So if you want to learn how to get away with all kinds of stuff, this is the keynote for you.
Don't miss this one.
Exactly. Yeah,
I'm looking forward to seeing that because obviously I've seen the movie, but you wonder how much is exact and how much changed.
That should be a really good one. Yeah. So. Yeah. All right. Well, this sounds like an awesome track. Thank you so much for putting it together.
It's the best track out there. So,
I'm sure it is.
You don't want to miss this.
I'm sure it is. And it's going to be a great summit. Like we said, it's at one of our favorite locations. So we want to have you join us there. We had such a great time in the evenings networking with everybody.
It's just so nice. There's nice places outside to sit and talk and just get to know everybody. And it's one of those places afterwards you feel like you've just made some new friends again, so it's really cool.
And you do that summit anyway, but this was even better.
Yeah.
All right, so thank you so much for joining us. Make your plans March 9th through the 13th, Horseshoe Bay, Texas. You can go to our website. Registration is actually open now.
It's open.
We're ready to go. Yep. So go online and register. You can participate in our early bird registration at this point and possibly win some great, usually Apple products.
Usually.
Yeah.
Mark's going with the Apple products, so we'll probably have those.
Yeah, and keep up with us on our social media because we'll have stuff all the time about what's going on at the summit. We're on podcasts. We're on iTunes on podcast and wherever. I think Steve's got us going to every podcast platform imaginable. Facebook, YouTube.
We got Twitter.
Twitter.
We tweet.
Instagram, Pinterest, you name it. If you need to find us, you can find us and go to our website to read all the awesome blogs. So thank you so much for joining us. Contact us if you need us, and we'll see you back here next week.
Bye-bye.
Thanks.